everyone. So this is the second part of your energy chapter physics, and in this session we will discuss about different forms of energy. So our topic of discussion for today is different forms of energy, and this topic is on your page number 57 physics. As we know, energy exists in different forms, or you can say there are different types of energy. And these forms are electrical energy, light energy, chemical energy, sound energy, heat energy, etc. So let's understand each topic one by one. Let's start with heat energy. Heat energy. What is heat energy? Well, heat energy is also known as thermal energy. Which is a form of energy. It always moves from your, or you can say always flows from the hotter body to the colder body, to the colder. Okay? For example, if a metal spoon is kept in a pot of boiling water, the spoon gets heated too, due to, and this is because of heat transfer. For example, suppose this is a pot of boiling water, okay? This is boiling water. And this is a spoon. So, if a metal spoon is kept in a pot of boiling water, the spoon gets heated too. And this is because the heat of the boiling water gets transferred to the spoon and it gets heated too. Now our next topic is light energy. What is light energy? Well, light energy is also a form of energy that makes things visible to us. With the help of light energy, we can see things. And the main source of light energy is sun, and other sources are like bulb, candle, torch. These are also some sources of energy, but the main source of light energy is sun. Okay, and light energy is used in photography. And see, the tail of the Halley's Comet increases when it comes nearer to the sun, and this is because of light energy. Okay, so Halley's Comet, which was seen in 1986 after 76 years, okay, and its tail increases when it comes nearer to the sun, okay, and this is because of the light energy. Okay, so this is the Halley's Comet, which was seen in 1986, and it still goes on increasing when it comes nearer to the sun. And this tail is formed when light rays fall on the dust particles around the comets. Okay. Now our next topic is sound energy, and it is on your page number 58. So what is sound energy? Well, sound energy is also a form of energy that produces the sensation of hearing in our ears. So sound energy is a form of energy that produces the sensation of hearing in our ears. Okay, and always remember that this sound energy is produced by a vibrating body, or you can say sound energy is produced when an object vibrates. So sound energy is produced by a vibrating body, where vibration is the motion of an object that moves forward and backward direction about its mean position. Mean position means the original position of an object. So when an object moves forward, backward direction about its mean position with a high speed, then this motion of an object is called vibration, and sound energy is produced due to vibration of an object. Okay, and the SI unit of sound energy is decibel. Okay, and its symbol is small d, capital B. So sound energy is measured by this unit decibel. Okay, and its symbol is small d, capital B. Okay, and the uses of sound energy is used for communication. So sound energy is used to communicate with each other. Sound energy is also used in music, isn't it? So this is all about sound energy. Now our next topic is electrical energy, and this topic is on your page number 58, physics. So what is electrical energy? Well, electrical energy, which is also known as current, is a form of energy which is caused by the movement of electrons from one place to another place. So electrical energy or current is a form of energy which is caused by the movement of electrons from one place to another place. Okay, and this current, the SI unit of current is ampere, and its symbol is capital A. So the SI unit of electrical energy or current is ampere, symbol capital A. Okay, and electrical energy is used throughout the wall to power devices. For example, electrical energy is used for running computers, it is also used for charging mobile, it is used in fan, bulb, etc. Okay? Now our next topic is chemical energy, and it is also on your page number 58, physics. So what is chemical energy? Well, energy which is stored in atoms or molecules of elements and compound is known as chemical energy. So energy stored in atoms or molecules of elements and compound of elements and compounds is known as chemical energy. Okay, and the main sources of chemical energy are food, fuels, electrical cell, atomic or nuclear energy, etc. Okay, now let's come to the topic food. What is food? Well, food is anything that we eat or drink, and always remember that carbohydrates and fats give us energy, and we human beings and animals eat food to get energy, and the energy stored in our food is chemical energy. Okay, then our next source of chemical energy is fuel. For example, coal, petroleum, no? So these are fuels, and it is used for running vehicles, to generate electricity, etc. Okay, next source of chemical energy is electrical cell, or you can say battery, which is also used to generate electricity, and the energy stored in battery or electrical cell is chemical energy, and it is used in torch, in inverter, etc. Okay, then our next source of chemical energy is atomic or nuclear energy. Atomic energy is also known as nuclear energy. So what is atomic or nuclear energy? Well, energy stored in the nucleus of an atom is called nuclear energy. So energy stored in the nucleus of an atom is called atomic or nuclear energy. And when it is produced, nuclear energy is produced when heavier elements like uranium, here U, capital U, is the symbol of uranium. So when heavier element splits its nucleus, to get stable, then lots of energy is produced, and this energy is called nuclear energy. And here this process, the splitting of nucleus into two nuclei, is called as nuclear fission. Nuclear fission. Here nuclear means nucleus, fission means splitting. Splitting of nucleus. So when an atom splits its nucleus to get stable, lots of energy is produced, and this energy is called nuclear energy. Okay, now let's answer these questions, and these questions are on your page number 66, physics. So your first question is match the column, and the first point is to switch on off an electric fan. So options are given here: chemical energy, potential, kinetic heat, electrical sound energy. So choose the correct answer. So it will be electrical energy. To switch on off an electric fan, electrical energy. So answer 1E. Okay, then your next point is the launching of a rocket. So which energy is stored in rocket? Chemical energy. So option will be chemical energy. So the correct answer is chemical energy. Then number 3, rubbing your palms together quickly, it will be heat energy.
So 3D answer. Okay. Then a tin can filled with water, it will be potential energy. So 4B. Okay. Then ringing of your school bell. Ringing of school bell, sound energy. So 5F. Okay. Now come to the next question. E1. Name the type of energy possessed by the following object. Number A. A suitcase kept on the head. So it will be potential energy. Potential energy. But you write in full form. Okay. Potential energy. Then 1B. A football moving on the playground. Energy in motion. What? Kinetic energy. So it will be kinetic energy. Okay. Then number C. A stretched spring. And number D. A compressed spring. So answer will be the same. It will be potential energy. Okay. C and D. Potential energy. A bird flying in the sky. So it is in motion. So it will be kinetic energy. Okay. So these are the answers of these questions.